that Manboy is now gone. How do you think the show is gonna continue to level up, man? Now that you kind of got one of those guys who kind of started with the show early on is now gone. Franklin Nuts dropped. He kind of about that aggressive life now. How you think he gonna go from, you know, he got these couple bodies on his belt now. He's serious. What do you think how Franklin life gonna turn now in the dope game?
Man, I think what's next, he gonna have to now that Manboy is gone, it's gonna be a free for all over there. And what was he at? Compton?
He was in Compton.
Yeah, okay. So it's probably gonna be a free for all. I feel like that's gonna be another thing that Franklin gonna have to go and get a hold of quick. He gonna have to jump on that because you don't want a free for all, and then he gonna have to deal with somebody else who's gonna try to come up and be the. He gonna try to run it. So I think Franklin gonna put somebody. This is what I'm thinking. He's gonna have to put somebody in contact. Like, okay, this is my guy. Now he goes through him, but I control Compton now. Cause I got Manboy up out of there, and now I'm the guy. I control it. You know what I mean? But you gonna have to see what's. Hey, Scully coming, bro. He gotta go get him, bro.
He gotta go get him too, bro. He gotta clean house, bro. You can't start it, get halfway through it, and then stop. You gotta get them all, bro. You gotta get Scully, baby
it's
mama.
It's about time though.
Yeah, because he kind of soft right now. Yeah. Oh, you think somebody on Franklin's side? Somebody gotta get
Yeah, bro. Come on, bro. If somebody got to go, nobody in your circle, everybody else in their circle, you done took out. Not one, you ain't gonna lose not one person in four. What is it? Five seasons? No, four.
Yeah,
it's four.
Four. Yeah, it got fat back, but you know what I'm saying? He really wasn't on the end circle anyway. He was more Leon. Yeah. He was more Leon boy.
Yeah, he more. So maybe they're gonna take the dad out, but that would be too predictable, right? In this next episode, they'll take the dad. They're gonna come for him. Reed gonna come for him.
Reed gonna get at him, bro, because Reed already, Reed like, look, we got it. I gotta get back on the inside. I gotta get back on the end. And the way I get back in is we're gonna get pops. I gotta go get pops. You know what I'm saying? If I get the pops out, I can kind of clear the slate. Like, all right, man, I took care of the situation. I'm ready to get back to work. We gotta get stuff done. Who gonna do it better than me? Because we gotta get somebody in there to build our relationships all over again. You know, Reed been doing this thing for the five seasons. Like, it's gonna be hard to try to get somebody back in there and try to build those relationships. Now you can get Javi back on the same team because, like, try to get Javi a new point of contact. Javi gonna walk all over them boy, man. Javi gonna try to get Reed for 15 million. You can imagine how much money he gonna take from these new boy.
Hey, Reed ain't gonna let that go. That's gonna come back. He gonna find out Javi stole that 15 million because here's the thing. If you remember, Javi taking that 15 million is what started was part of Reed's downfall. Because the monies didn't get, I mean, the, so the money,
the guns didn't get delivered.
So they started losing ground on the war.
Mm-hmm.
And he going to kill Javi. Once he found out, Javi is going to be on the run. Reed, Reed ain't playing. He know Reed
don't play, bro. Reed don't play, bro. He about that action. He low key be getting it. He low key about that action, bro. He ain't like, you know what I'm saying, Gustavo, where he go beat up somebody, blah, blah, blah. He like, nah, man, I'm going to catch you on the low, put these slugs in you.
Yeah, you don't even see it coming. He look like a regular just white boy who drank too much, sniffing no coke. He coming in, bro. Talking all, breathing, and that man about to put that needle in your neck.
So just to see that whole situation and just to see how, you know what I'm saying, how Franklin's crew be thinking, because Sissy was in the bed, you know, she was like, you got to go get a Dallas. She's like, you got to get Dallas. Dallas, you know what I'm saying? He's like, how you going to get out? He's like, man, she going to go for the money. You know what I'm saying? And then he was like, you know what? Let's see. Like, you think they're going to work? He's like, man, they might work. So it lets you know his whole crew, you know, I'm going to say whole crew, but you know what I'm saying? You know, you have Louie and him, they thinking, you know what I'm saying? You got to have these people who thinking your crew. You can't be just you can't just be reacting off emotion the whole time, man. When you're dealing with life or death situation, man, you got to be able to be logical and think about stuff. You know what I mean? And so that's basically how Manboy got caught up. He was thinking, but he wasn't thinking two steps ahead like Franklin was. You know what I'm saying? Franklin still was thinking two steps ahead. He was like, man, I'm going to settle.
He wasn't patient, bro. He pressed her. So, you know, he wasn't
made her get sloppy. That's what messed up the whole thing. He pressed on her on time and made her get sloppy. And then she get caught and Frank can catch wind of what she doing. Cause you know what I'm saying? He had been laying, she had been laying the weeds for what, for a few months. You know what I'm saying? The way she was talking.
That wasn't Manboy fault. You know who that fault was? That was Khadija. Wouldn't sit low. Cause remember she put the hit out. And Manboy was like, damn, you messing, up.
I got stuff in motion. Like if he'd have told, maybe if he told her the whole play, you know what I'm saying? Maybe she would have calmed down, but she was just in such a rage, bro, to just kind of get back at Leon so bad. She was just such a rage that it really blew everything up, you know what I mean? Because she just out in the street causing havoc.
Yeah.
She out there causing havoc, bro.
Causing havoc. And he told her to calm down. But, you know, her baby got, I understand her baby gets shot, so she emotional. But Manboy would have had it. Manboy would, because, bro.
He wouldn't have figured it out.
Didn't even see that coming.
He didn't even see it, bro. Like he had been. Think about it. She had been there for months, so he had already been doing drop offs. They've been doing getting loads. He been being around. He had been around Frank.
She seen the plug. She just didn't know who it was.
She just didn't know who it was. She was like, who's the white boy? Who's the white boy? You know what I'm saying? And that's what kind of like, he was like, especially when they was in that room that day, he was like, it was nobody. It was just somebody come by the club, whatever, whatever. She ain't really telling who it was. But had she known who the plug was then, it would have been OV. It would have been over, bro. It would have been over because they followed him from the club. So she already set him up and everything. She didn't know who the plug was, but she knew where he was going to meet. He was like, hey, look, just sit on the club. He going to ride out with Peaches. You follow the car and you're going to go get the plug. That wasn't good enough for them. You know what I'm saying? That wasn't good enough for Manboy. He kept pressing her. And she started getting sloppy, started slipping. And then it was just one little thing that Franklin caught. He like, man, T playing me.
Next thing you know, Manboy on the ground, bleeding out his mouth.
Bro.
You got that, bah! Got that slug in him.
Hey. You got this slug, bop, bop.
But yeah, bow. Man, it's going to be this next episode, bro. See, I thought this past episode was going to be the season finale.
Going to be the finale. Me too. I didn't know they were going to give it episode 10 because they gave us two in the beginning. I thought that was going to be this is going to be the last one. You know, they give us 9 with 10 would have been that one or whatever. But they're going to give us one more. So, man, I think it's going to be even more epic, bro. I'm so excited how they didn't let this show fall to the wayside. You know what I mean? Like, it could have easily fell off with not having John Singleton, you know what I'm saying, finger on it. You know what I'm saying, his thumbprint. Because, you know, we know how them John Singleton movies shot. We know how the lingo. We know how it go. But for him not to be around and the show still to kind of continue to level. Bro, this season was such a great season, bro. Normally when you get, you know, a show, when it gets to like this fourth season, it kind of starts slowing down. It kind of starts stretching it out. But it seems like they just hitting a peak where it's just not starting to ramp up. Because like I said, Franklin Nuss dropped. He got the plug set up. You know what I'm saying? He's starting to get his infrastructure. He got some hitters on his team. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, he just got out of high school. No, we were pressing him for to be.
Yeah.
We were just pressing him for to be aggressive, fresh out of high school. But like he probably like what 20? He probably 20?
Yeah, 20 now. 20, and it wouldn't have been 20, believable. 21? It wouldn't be believable for a dude like Franklin, how he grew up, where he was at, like you said, the prep school, trying to go to a nice college, working mom. It wouldn't have made sense. Yeah, it wouldn't have made sense, bro. So
it wasn't like him. It wasn't like he would come out the projects. He, you know what I'm saying, foot the mouth the whole time. You know, he got to make it work because they was okay, but they weren't, you know what I'm saying, his mama was working. You know what I'm saying, dad on drugs. I mean, dad was alcoholic. You know, all of a sudden you kind of see that turn. Like you even see in the clothing attire that they're wearing when they first, like the first couple of seasons when they were kind of broke and had in there, and they start leveling up that money. You see Jerome wearing that fur. You see Louis wearing them gold chains. Everybody getting, you know what I'm saying, everybody leveling up, getting these watches. You know, even though they just ain't riding on fancy cars and getting them big houses, but you can just see in their clothing attire that they start leveling up. They start making money. So I think the show is just really on a nice arc, bro. Like they can keep rising up because this probably was the best episode this season. It's probably the best episode this season to me.
Yeah, I mean, I can agree with that. I can agree with that. You know,
I thought those first two episodes were bang bang. I'm thinking that was like some of the hardest episodes. Then they had a couple. They laid down a little bit. Kind of built the momentum. You know what I'm saying, built the story plot, and then they just came with this episode. Like it went down, bro. It went down.
Yeah, it went down. It did its thing. Hey, John Singleton don't miss with them LA movies, them LA shows. He ain't miss with, bro, Boys in the Hood. But hey, people sleep on Baby Boy. Hey, he did. That was spot on.
Yeah, and that role was supposed to be for Pop.
Yep, Baby Boy. LA. He was on. Now,
yeah, he just Snowfall, got his, he just
LA.
Got,
yeah. And yeah, you know, he's from LA, so he know.
He know, bro. There's such a period piece where you can see the 80s, man. It's in the clothing and the cars and the houses and the decoration in the houses. You know what I mean? Like, it's all, like I said, it's all spot on. Like, they really got attention to detail. And that's what I really like about the show. Like, you feel like you in the 80s. You feel like the crack epidemic is starting to take off. You feel it.
Oh,
you can feel a rise with Franklin. You can just feel like, okay, he go to Oakland. They show him how to rock it up. And he take it back to Oakland, take it back to the streets.
We had to game him. You know what I mean? You had to game him. Come up here. We gonna put you, because at first you down in LA, you game goofy. We gonna put you on game. You gonna rock go to LA, up. Rock it up, baby.
Came to the town, they showed him how to rock it up. He come back down to LA, put them on game, put it out in the hood. They making real good money. And he gotta go through the whole situation with his homeboy. He had to off his homeboy. You know what I'm saying?
They call him old snitching ass Kevin.
had off the homie. You know what I'm saying? Because he out here tripping. You know what I'm saying? Had off
Kevin
the homie.
Was on. He was playing with that shit too.
Yeah,
he was on the nose candy already.
Yep.
I don't think he rocked it up.
Yeah. No, they had. That's when they first got it. You know, it was in their bedroom that time. They tried it out. You know, what I'm saying? They all coked up, and so he's like, oh shit, I like this. You know what I'm saying? I like this.
Yeah. And so Leon stopped. Kevin didn't, you know.
Yeah, and then you know what I'm saying, Leon kind of get that first body, and they out in Maryland. Franklin couldn't pull the trigger. Leon like, give me that shit, man.
Give me that. He went, what's that boy's name?
He want
Kelt, whatever to do. Hey, he said, bro, ain't about to be pumping me like he was doing, bro. Give me the gun, bro. I'm about to take him out. Wow. Hey, he ain't about to work me up in there.
Hey, they had them boys scared in the front room, bro. They were scared, bro.
Scared. They didn't even look. Lee just told him, like, hey, nah, bro. You don't want to see what he's doing. You don't want to see what he's doing in there. But, hey, that's when Lee was like, hey, we got to kill this nigga.
Yeah, it's going down because he ain't going, bro. He ain't going.
Lee was like, bro, that dude ain't about to have me up in here pumping in the sweat, man. It's dig on me, bro.
Yeah, but like I said, man, they've been doing such a great job. I just want